Wow. I'm excited to have everyone here. And we're gonna be learning our graduate training relocated to Canada within 16 straight days, without using any travel agent or submitting IELTS or TOEFL academic test results, following the three most neglected secrets revealed to a top travel coach. And how you, yes, you watching me right now, can follow this same easy pathway to Canada, even in 2021. You know what? Let me know where you're watching from quickly. I'm doing this live call or live webinar training from Manitoba here in Canada, and I'd like to know where you're watching me from. Okay, Paulina from Makurdi, Phillips from Abuja, Jibrim from Lokoja, Gakuru from Mombasa, wow, Daniel from Dubai, okay, Abaka from Ilorin, Jeffrey from Mina, Rose from Kisumu, Jerifaima from Jos, Zara from Nairobi, Basi from Oyo, Emmanuel from Bayelsa, Chipong from Takrady, John from Calabar, Samuel from Owerri, Machupa from Nairobi, Olusola from Ibadan, Joe from Borgatanga. Wow, where is that? Who else? Chitundu from Kisumu. Samson from Cape Coast. Ofori Atta from Accra. Ania from Takoradi. And Waitimu from Eldoret. Wow, where's that? Eldoret. I got. And then we also have Sam from Cayman Island. Wow. This is gonna be massive. I mean, we have people in thousands and thousands watching me right now. All right, let me quickly move on to the next one so we don't slow down on that. Who is this webinar training for? Anyone IELTS or TOEFL is stopping your relocation to Canada goals? Age is limiting your CRS cutoff call. I mean, maybe you are too young or you're too old. If you have zero or no work experience, which is preventing you from moving to Canada permanently, your education and qualification isn't enough to immigrate permanently, or you don't have any form of ties or relation in Canada, so you're losing out extra points to enter the express entry pool. Okay, so let me make a promise right now. I mean, at the end of this live call, you will see how to fast track your relocation legally to Canada in 2021 without writing IELTS or TOEFL examination. You will know how to get your work permit and open work permit for your spouse if you have one. Then, I mean, you will learn how to successfully relocate your family to Canada legally, including your kids. And I'm also telling you will see why you don't really need to rely on any travel agent. Will prey on your ignorance and fear of visa denial, which is just so baseless. And also, you will see how to become a Canadian permanent resident and eventually become a citizen within 3 years. Okay, like this man here, he failed IELTS 3 times, got scholarship plus research assistantship. I mean, he said, as I was looking online for getting my master's degree in computer science abroad, I was getting so many recommendations regarding one agency or the other. I mean, along the line, I found out about web class organized by VO, and I just fell in love with the idea of no IELTS. I mean, I failed it 3 times before, no TOEFL, and even doing the application myself, which I believe will save me some coins. After thoroughly going through the no IELTS training guide, I was able to get scholarship later of $20,000. Wow, guys, that's huge. I mean, if you know that from UNISASK, that is Saskatoon, even with my 2.2 CGPA, thus I don't have to show huge money in my bank account for my visa application. Within 4 months of landing in Saskatoon, that is Saskatchewan, I had to decide to pick between a research assistantship job on campus or customer service gig outside campus. I later chose the campus job because I do like academics. Thanks to Victor for support through the way. Thanks, my man Charles. Okay. If you stay to the end, you know what? I will be answering your questions regarding relocation to Canada in 2021. You will get my complete WhatsApp number, that is +504 254 to ask for the personal travel questions. I also have a yet announced, I mean, yet to be announced gift for you. I mean, that's a surprise, you know? So, I mean, who is this guy blabbing and talking? Who is Victor? I mean, I'm Vio. I'm popularly called Vio. I'm Nigerian born, but global citizen. I mean, some people call me a travel abroad educational consultant. I've helped over 137 people, both family and individuals, move to Canada successfully, and thousands of students currently putting in their application. You know what? I share quality travel information and updates with over 140,000 readers across West, East, Central, and South Africa, weekly, even Middle East. You know, I also manage the largest and growing Canadian hopeful audience across West Africa on Telegram in their tens of thousands, as you can see that on the screen. You know, recently, I think my info story broke the internet. It was all over the media outlet, both the mainstream and the wannabe media blogs. You can see that how Victor Lah has been supporting people get scholarship and travel to Canada without writing out or wasting $8 and travel agent. That is from The Nation. That is a tweet from legit.ng. That is also a tweet from The Guardian Nigeria. You know, three unique secret. I mean, chronicling my story, three unique secret. I used to study in Canada for free, get a professional job, and settle down permanently. I mean, that's from a tweet from The Guardian News. And also, there was this story of Mrs. Ajibola family that I also supported, that currently they will be moving to Canada by December 2020. That was from Punch also. That was there. You know, the news, it's been a while. So the news was that they'll be moving to Canada by December 2020. So my news is everywhere and all of that. So that's it. Let me stop at that point and move on to the next thing. So AY Canada, you asked, you know what? Canada is ranked number one quality of lifestyle, healthcare, light, road, transport, and all civic and luxurious amenities provided. That was a tweet from the Prime Minister. I said, I agree, this is the best place in the world to live right now. And we are going to keep working to make sure every Canadian has a real and fair chance at success. Also, someone was asking in a forum called Quora, he said, is it wise to migrate to Canada at present? And it was replied, I mean, you can't go wrong with Canada. Okay, AY Canada, you asked. This was another tweet. Somebody said, asked that you guys that left Nigeria, what was the final straw that made you decide to leave? And this man replied, I said, dropped off a friend traveling from Tubini at God is Good, Ajapak, early morning. While I headed to my office in VI, she called 4.5 hours later that she was in Bini. I hadn't reached Lekki Phase 1 roundabout. Called my wife immediately to say, I yield. You are leaving. I mean, those terrible Lagos traffic. This was another tweet from someone said, no matter how rich you are in Nigeria, you will never get truly value. You will drive your Rolls Royce inside the flood. When you drive out of your mansion, you will enter a portal. If you have an accident, ambulance won't show up. I mean, there's no immunity to collective poverty. Yeah, that's what I used to tell my Nigerian folks. I mean, it's now a collective poverty. You are not exempted. You know what? AY Canada, you still ask. My passport is currently number six most powerful passport. That is, with your Canadian passport, you have visa-free access to 183 countries. Tell me in the chat box, I want to know, do you desire a Canadian passport? Oh, wow, I love Canadian passport. Wow, I need Canadian passport. Oh, I want Canadian passport. All right, let me stop at that. I mean, with a Canadian passport, you do not require visa to visit United States of America, United Kingdom of Great Britain, Germany, Japan, Ireland, Italy, Sweden, and Norway. I mean, isn't that cool? Let us go through this review for someone who has gone through this no ICS to guide training. He said, Many thanks to Vio. This guy is actually an angel in human skin. Wow, I'm blushing right now. Thank you. He said he has a large heart, and despite all debt thrown at him, he still continues to do what he believed in, which is relocation to Canada with an IELTS program. Yes, a whole lot of people do attack me, and they still attack me that it's not possible, but you go on. So I found his online article in my search to relocate to any country permanently with my family in 2019. Even though I was already 42 years with MSc Applied Computing from University of Nairobi, oh, that's my Kenyan people, said through his no IELTS to Canada training, I realized I could relocate with my age and even my family. I have learned a lot on this journey, from how to seek for potential supervisor up to getting passport request. I was able to get my PhD admission in electronic system engineering, University of Regina. I learned how to sell myself in my application. I discussed about my knowledge of machine learning using Python. I mentioned my plan upon return to my home country after my studies, advised by Victor. Even though I will be staying back after my studies and have my family join me here in Canada, I submitted my visa application online on June 30th. I did my biometrics August 24th, got my passport request on November 11th, 2020. I thank God others could read my own success story as I read that of others in 2019. Wow. When I came in contact with Vio, I mean, truly, we will be many. Thanks, Mr. Mukuru. That's Mr. Mukuru Adamu, an electrical contractor from Nairobi. Okay. You know what? Do you know that you are one decision away from relocating to Canada legally in 2021? Do you know that? Do you know Canada is truly waiting for you in 2021? You ask, how do I know? Without immigration, Canada's population growth could be close to zero in 20 years, that is. Or if not for immigrant, in the next 20 years, there will be no one left in Canada. Okay? If I may ask, if you learn all you need to learn to relocate to Canada now, will you start preparing and packing your bags? Tell me in the chat box. I want to know, will you start packing your bags? Yes. All right. Yes, I'm ready. Okay. I mean, pay 100% rapt attention. Switch off your TV and radio set. Close the door to your room for better privacy. Shut down your social media account. You don't need that right now. You don't need Twitter or Facebook and Instagram. Grab your pen and paper and be ready to write. Oh, sorry. Quickly, let's also see this review from someone who has also gone through this NOAA to Canada training. He said, I got my visa approval in 45 days in the midst of pandemic, organizational sponsor, and also 3,114 what Canadian dollars in bursary. Okay, he said, my story is filled with delay, but it has ended in praise. I'd finished my BSc compute mobile computing from Ghanaian Communication Tech University. When I came across Victor Advert in the middle of 2020 and chatted him up about my situation, I had already gotten admission then into Simon Fraser University for September 2020. And time was running out for my visa application. I was given access to the No IELTS to Canada guide, and I kickstarted my application, which took 45 days. I stubbornly didn't defer my admission and just followed Victor guidance to continue my education. My passport request came out September 16th, and my program at SFU started September 14th. Wow. I used my organization account for my sponsorship with extra details. Okay, these are my document details I submitted during my application. I had my personal bank statement, which was barely 5,000 Ghanaian cedis. I prepared my letter of explanation in a convincing way, appealing to the visa officer emotions. Just also to let you know that I am in my week 10 of studies with SFU, and I got bursary this term worth 3,114 Canadian dollars. I'm really grateful to Victor for all he did. That is Kwashi Kojo. Yeah, he used to be a private university staff in Accra. I mean, his story is really, really amazing. know what? Results aren't typical. And I will walk you through the exact guide we are using to get this great result. The average person who attends training like this never takes action or already learn, hence they gain zero results, okay? However, I'm showing you what's working for many of my students who has gone through this training. And lastly, this isn't for people who want to do nothing and expect magical results, okay? Wow, let's get started. How a graduate trainee relocated to Canada within 60 straight days without using any travel agent or submitting IELTS or TOEFL academic test result following the three most neglected secrets revealed to a top travel coach, and how you, that you're listening to me right now, can follow the same pathway to Canada in 2021. Okay, so what is this three most neglected secrets? Secret number one, you can relocate to Canada legally without using any travel agent or knowing any embassy official. Let us sink, okay? Secret two, you can relocate to Canada using this most reliable pathway to Canada in 90 days or less without writing academic IELTS or TOEFL or GRE exam. Let that sink too. Secret number three, you can relocate to Canada at almost no major cost, all right? So about secret number one, there is two myths people ask about visa agents or travel agencies. The lie, your subconscious is saying to you, you can't do it yourself. But the truth, you can apply and get any visa yourself. And you know what? Nearly half of visa applicants know it. Most are just gripped by fear, which is the fear of visa denial. And you know, the fear is just baseless, and it's just the fear of the unknown. What if those who had fallen victims knew that they could have avoided being praised in the hand of predator turned visa agent? Huh? Baba Tunde himself was denied visa twice because he used a charlatan turned visa agent. You know, this lady is saying agents in Nigeria demand 500K. Another person here, I mean, Ada Freeman said, Canadian immigration lawyer asked me to pay $3,000. It's just, she was asking, said, do you think I can do it alone? My agent, a lawyer in Canada, said I should pay $3,000. Isn't that way too much? I mean, the truth is, it's not way too much. $3,000 isn't way too much. But you have to be smart, okay? Isn't way too much? There are immigration lawyers charging up to $5,000. But I'm here to show you how you don't need all of that. I mean, and do it all by yourself. Okay, another myth people believe is visa application success is entirely 100% guaranteed. But the truth is this, it's laughable saying flyers with print like visa success 100% guaranteed. I mean, I wonder if the the embassy of whatever country, those people offer their visa services are on promo, or your agent is a friend to the country president. We have few countries that has 100% guaranteed, like Dubai and many African countries as an African immigrant or a white immigrant. I mean, the rest are 98% after all has been done, after you've put in your application very well. So even your seasoned travel agencies or exceptional visa agents can only put all the best required documentation together to sell you to the visa officer. They are in the alpha and omega of your visa application. You know what? Granting a visa is the sole discretion of visa officer. You know, the difference between you and any travel agent is access to accurate information. Like this person chatted me up. I mean, people wonder, why are you doing this? Why are you doing all of that? I mean, my heart bleeds. Like this chat I had with this person sometimes ago. He said, a travel agent duped me of about 1.2 million naira. And I mean, I later got to know he was issued fake employment letter. He said, hello, I'm Oye Banjo. I was part of your Webster attendant. Please, I've been duped by all this called agent worth over 1.205 million of traveling to Canada, but alas, nothing to show for it. I mean, I later realized it was issued a fake employment offer. And this person also, he met me some time ago. He said, hello, good afternoon. My name is, I covered that, and I'll tell you something soon about that. I attended your webinar and wanted to say a few things. So I've tried twice to relocate to Canada with my wife and daughter in 2018, 2019, but ended up being duped one way or the other by different agents. Oh, it's not even one agent. I've lost over 2 million naira in this regard. Let me stop at that because of a thing. I mean, he wasted 2 million naira on fake agent. My heart bleeds. I mean, my heart bleeds. Anytime I hear things like this, my heart just, I mean, shattered. I wonder, 2 million naira, nothing to show. Okay, let me tell you about something briefly as we move on. I intentionally covered all those people's name because in time past, I didn't find it funny. I've done several webinars and I open people's details and contact details, and people began to email, phone call, and do all of that. And these people are private people who don't want their stuff to be shared publicly, and they started reaching out to me. I mean, some almost they didn't take it lightly with me. So since then, I've learned my lesson, and you know what I said. I'm not going to show any people contact detail any longer for no reason. So that's why henceforth you can't see all of my students. I mean, they want to maintain their privacy. Okay. So why you don't really need a travel agent or visa agency? 87.5% of visa agents you knew working their services online, offline, operate with half-baked info, which in the end spoil your visa reputation. And you face penalty of 5 years ban to top countries while using fake documents in the name of packaging you. You lose the old money you paid for their service. In the end, you have nothing to lose. I mean, they have nothing to lose, but you have all to lose. I will be sharing stories of many people here who never use any agent after going through our guide. You know what? Can you truly see you don't need any so-called agent to fulfill your Canadian relocation goals? Reply me right now in the comment box. Yes. Oh, yes. Let me get three more. Yes. Three, four. Yes, five. Yeah. Oh, good. Secret number two. How to relocate using the most reliable pathway to Canada in 90 days without writing academic IELTS or TOEFL exam? People like me don't like writing anything called exam. I don't know about you, okay? Why IELTS, the International English Language Testing System, is designed to assess the language ability of candidates who need to study or work where English is used as a language of communication. And you know what the untold secret is? In recent times, this examination body has been dealing with anyone writing it for purpose of immigration or going to study. They score you low. They want to keep making money off you. And the cost of average examination, one sitting, is 75,000 naira or 980 Ghanaian cedis or 180 Great Britain pounds. Okay, like this person Twitter says, so this Nigerian man wrote IELTS 32 times, all because they want to leave Nigeria. 32 freaking times, oh boy. He said, lost. I mean, that's over 2.4 million naira. I mean, that's over 600,000 Kenyan shillings. That's over 35,000 Ghanaian cedis. And that's almost 6,000 US dollars. So if you find a way not to write any IELTS or TOEFL exam to fulfill your relocation goal, will you follow it? I need your reply. Yes, I will. Yes. Okay. Sit tight, the game changer. I myself immigrated without writing IELTS or TOEFL or GRE some years ago, and I want to show you the step-by-step guide how I did it. I am ready to provide this information to anyone interested to come to Canada and could prove they were taught an English language while in school. This same practical guide has been used by 137 people, both individuals and family, to come to Canada. Then I also spoke with my Nigerian friend, who is a trained and certified travel expert, and is HATA qualified. He has worked with hundreds of Canadian African immigrants in the past 17 months. Saviors Daniel provided me with the clarity and up-to-date information. So before I talk about this most reliable pathway, the most popular pathway to relocate to Canada as a permanent residence with your entire family is through either the Express Entry or the Provisional Nomination Program. But if you move through this to Canada, this pathway to Canada, you will face two big challenges. I mean, I kid you not, I know what's obtainable here. Number one, Canadian experience. Most companies and recruiters prefer to hire someone who has work background in Canada than outside Canada. Yes, that's it. It won't matter your educational qualification or work experience back in your home country. Number two, challenge number two is Canadian education. You will need to enroll for a diploma, minimum of a diploma or degree program to be able to work in your primary profession or change to a lucrative job in the environment you find yourself. Eventually, you have to work and study to integrate yourself properly into the Canadian economy. But it's worth it, right? It's worth it. You know, people earning, let's say, 100,000 naira, or let's say they're earning below 100 Ghanaian cedis or whatever, back in their home country. And you come around here and you begin to earn in thousands of dollars. So it's worth it, okay? The most reliable pathway solves, this pathway solves the imminent challenge all new immigrants in Canada faces. It removes all the stumbling block created by Express Entry or Provisional Nomination Program. More than 50% of Canadian immigrants uses this pathway. Why this pathway to Canada? It doesn't matter if you don't have IELTS or TOEFL. You can be 18 or 50. Doesn't matter if you have zero or no work experience. Doesn't matter if all you have is your highest secondary school certificate and you can prove you're taught in English language. Doesn't matter even if you don't have any form of ties or relation in Canada. This most reliable pathway allows you to work for up to 20 hours per week, obtain a postgraduate work permit before processing your permanent residency, bring an accompanying spouse or common law partner to Canada on an open full-time work permit, bring an accompanying minor children, put them in a high-quality Canadian public school to graduate, become eligible permanent resident, and eventually citizen within the space of 3 years. The unique and fastest pathway is called, drumrolls, Study Education Route to Relocating to Canada Permanently. You study, you work, and you become a permanent resident. The study could be academic or professional or vocational. Quickly, the case study of Babatunde is he failed out twice. He has low proof of fund. Let's quickly see what he said. He said, I currently gained admission to University of Saskatchewan to pursue MSc in Anatomy and Cell Biology. Initially, I had no idea how to proceed with my study permit application and also to deal with other related matters. Aside the typical challenges that students who apply for Canada visa encounter, I had an extra challenge. I don't have enough proof of fund, and I had failed out twice. The guide created by Victor Ola and Saviors helped me to put together all the paperwork for submission on Canadian website. In the end, my visa application came out successful. Wow. He got two kinds of scholarship, which is $17,800 Canadian, and he was also able to secure a part-time lab job. Isn't that cool? Do you also want to get a scholarship and a part-time job while you're studying in Canada like Babatunde? Let me see your comment. Let me see your response. Yes, I want scholarship. Yes, yes, yes. Wow, that's good. Yeah, you know what? To now process a permanent residence in Canada, he didn't need high IELTS score. He didn't need any proof of funds. He's working legally and living in Canada. He has a Canadian education already. He has a Canadian work experience. He will easily scale through the required CRS cutoff using the Canadian experience class and finally obtain a Canadian passport for himself. Don't you like you have one? Let me see. I need one. I want it. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, yes. Like this lady tweeted, 4 years in Canada, 3 years of postgrad study permit, six plus jobs doing co-op and postgraduate work permit together. And I became a Canadian permanent resident today. Let me ask you a question. You know what? We've been talking for about 30 minutes, had lots of fun, sharing cool stuff to help you relocate fast, but really a short time to cover the detailed process to follow. If there's a way to continue this training to the very end and learn every damn process involved till you land in Canada and get your first job and even relocate with your family, how many of you listeners will be interested? How many? Let me see. Yes, I will be interested. Yes, I'm interested. Oh, let me stop. Let me stop. Just keep it coming. I'm a team I've put together a step-by-step process to do it by yourself over the next 90 days and start to pack your bags to come to Canada. Do you mind me taking you through what's inside the No IELTS to Canada guide? Do you mind? Yes, let me see your response. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. Now let me introduce you to the same guide Baba today used to relocate to Canada through the study pathway. No IELTS to Canada guide, a street credible practical guide to get your Canada PR without using any travel agent, either you are 18 or 50. All right. All right. What you get inside this guide, you don't need IELTS or TOEFL or GRE or West transcript evaluation. Step-by-step guide on securing admission and scholarship from Canadian schools. Number two, list of schools that give you guaranteed entrance scholarship. Number three, verify list of schools that doesn't require IELTS or TOEFL, accept English proficiency letter occasionally, and how to get it. Number four, list of schools to apply if you have two tutor class or pass. You are eligible if you don't have any form of higher education, but credit pass and five core subjects in your secondary school examination also. Number five, you learn how to find funded master's and doctoral programs that will help you achieve your goals and learn how to make faculty connection to strengthen your candidacy, which includes finding supervisor in your choice of school. That is very important. Number six, you get sample personal statement and letters to supervisor by students that already got scholarships. Let me quickly go through the story of this family. She was admitted into nursing program even with 12 years study gap and relocated with her family. She said, "Our Canada story won't be possible without God and huge support of VO. We had been reading through different articles online with regard to relocation and found out about the No IELTS to Canada program in one of the online newspaper. I was a bit skeptical initially about the No IELTS exam relocation route, but my husband told me we should give it a try. Through the help of the No IELTS training guide, I was able to secure admission summer 2019 to study enhanced nursing practice in one of the Ontario colleges, even with 12-year study gap. And my visa took almost 4 months before our approval. Afterwards, I deferred my admission to winter, and my husband put in his open work permit application, which took us 2 months before approval. With my 7-year-old son and 11-year-old daughter, study visa. After safe landing in Kitchener, Ontario, my husband was able to secure a banking job after writing mutual exam funds, and I also got a home care assistant work here. I can boldly say the journey wasn't easy, but it was worth it. Thanks to Victor, my main boss. Thanks, Mr. Joy. You know what? I mean, that's one thing I do tell people. Your main challenge is to come to Canada. Forget about all these enticing job offers here and there that some people throw around using to scam you. Your main challenge is to arrive here. And this is the easiest way to come. Once you land here, either you want to go after your studies, you want to go to the Atlantic region or the rural region to find jobs. I mean, it is so easy for you instead of being scammed from your home country. Number seven, you learn how to position yourself for research or teaching assistantship. Number eight, how to apply for master's degree in Canada as an HND holder, how to increase your chances of approval for Canadian study visa, how to fill your visa application form currently to the point of submission online, how to apply for open work permit for your spouse if you have one, how to relocate your family successfully, and how to transition to permanent residence in Canada. You know what? If you wait till the end, I'm going to redeem my three promises. All right? As if that's not enough, you'll be getting these extra bonuses. 12-month unlimited update about how to relocate, live, and prosper in Canada. Documents, whiteboards, I mean, academic CV, visa SOP, personal statement, recommendation letter, sponsorship letter. I mean, it's worth over $500. Items you can bring to Canada when coming here. You can't just bring anything. You can bring more. Yeah, that is heights from my home country. You can't bring it. You will be fined at the airport, I think, between $1,000 and $2,000, sites to check for accommodation and jobs in Canada, a step-by-step guide of how to avoid visa denial, they're going to be getting over 20 real case studies of those who got their study visa approved. I mean, I'll be showing you, I'll be giving, handing over to you, landing 40 landing gist of how people settle successfully here in Canada. And also, you'll be learning about 7 odd skills to learn before moving to Canada. And these skills can put, I mean, between $1,500 to $2,000 monthly in your pocket. I mean, and obviously, I am not going to charge you the total value worth, which is $3,300, even though it's worth it. All right. If I may ask, if all the No IELTS to Canada guide did was to give you step-by-step guide till you land in Canada without writing IELTS or TOEFL exam, wouldn't it be worth it? Okay. If all the No IELTS to Canada guide did was to show you how to land a decent job while studying in Canada, would it be worth it? Okay. If all the No IELTS to Canada guide did was to show you step by step of how to get open work permit for your spouse and relocate your entire family, I ask again, would it be worth it? All right. So now I'm giving you whopping 93% discount. Yes. Yeah. So that makes it $199. That's a must, right? Instead of paying your scrupulous agent $3,000. But wait, let me redeem my one of my unannounced gifts, as I promise you, at the beginning of those who at the beginning for those who wait till now. So for the next 19 minutes, I mean, this is a major offer now. For the next 19 minutes, as we close this web class, you get it for, you know what, $55 in dollars. You get it for 19,999 naira. If you're from Nigeria, you get it for 332 Ghanaian cedis from Ghana. If you're from Kenya, you get it for 6,305 Ghanaian shillings. And if from every other location, you get it for the local currency equivalent worth. So because you're waiting now anyway. But you know, like I told you, coupon code expires one discount that timer hit zero. And you get it once it hits zero like this, you get it for $199, or I mean your local currency equivalent, which is still worth it instead of paying your scrupulous agent three or $5,000. Okay, I mean, people ask, the whole school people in my trainees do ask, how safe is my card to make payment on your website? Let me tell you, our payment page is fully secured and built with bank-grade security features. We don't store any customer credit card details. As a result, it can never be stolen. I mean, what you don't have, how can it be stolen? We don't de with the we deploy Rave, or the people also call, they also called Flutterwave payment processor, and also Paystack. We deploy both Paystack and Rave payment processor, which is a PCI DSS compliant. This certification is a proof that they have satisfied highest level of global security audit. We use them to collect payment from customers in over 7 currencies. I mean, dollars, Kenyan shilling, dirham, rand, cedis, and naira, and all of that. Okay. You know what? Right on your screen now, either you're using a desktop, laptop, or a phone device, you're going to see an icon called offer and a button